our virtual grandparents day. We're glad that you're here. We hope you have a wonderful morning. Welcome to the lower school. Enjoy your visit.
Romans 15:13. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace as you trust in him, so that you may overflow with hope by the power of the Holy Spirit.
Good morning, grandparents. My name is Bear. I'd like to give you a tour of DC Lower School on a normal school day.
Good morning, Mr. Penguin. I hope somebody gives you something good today.
The kids have arrived. Here we go.
Morning meetings give us practice in social skills like speaking and listening politely to our friends. We also pray for each other.
During school, we learn about God's world by reading, working out math problems, learning to speak and write clearly.
We attend special subject classes to sing and learn music, to exercise and compete, learn Spanish, do art, type, and hear stories.
Graders get to play in band. They make a lot of noise.
We learn inside the building and outside too. God has blessed our school with so many neat places to learn outside.
Lunch and recess give us time to hang with our friends and just talk and play and run around.
after school clubs and homework club add enrichment to our school day. Field trips, service projects, special events, and concerts are fun too. Once a week, we gather to sing and worship during chapel. We have learned this year that God is a God of hope because He is strong and faithful and loving. He fills us with joy and peace as we trust in Him. God's love for us never changes because it is based on who He is. Throughout a school day here at DC, we learn who God is and what He is like. As we learn to trust in Him, He causes us to overflow with hope.
Hope was a good theme for this year. Hope in God is a perfect hope, because God is perfect. He never changes. But as you know, in our world, everything has changed. On Friday, March 13th, we sent the students home with extra bags full of most of their school books and supplies, not knowing when they would be back in the building. Our teachers took a crash course on teaching over the internet. And by Tuesday, March 17th, everyone was doing school from home. Morning announcements and morning meetings through Zoom or Google Hangouts are still an important part of our school days. Teachers are able to keep students connected to each other and praying for each other while they are apart. Students are learning social skills in a very different way. Teachers still meet every morning to read God's Word together and pray too. Each school day, Google Classrooms give teachers a way to post teaching videos and assignments.
Hey everybody, I'm back with you today with another installment of the Great Tennis Ball Challenge.
Twinkle, twinkle, little star.
Boing, boing. Respond.
And we toss it under our leg to the same hand.
Skinnamarinky dinky dink, skinnamarinky doo.
Three for five. 100 in a row for credit.
have hedgehogs in your head.
Lost my mouse again, but there it is. All right, see you next time.
Parents and students are working together from home to keep the learning going and to turn in their assignments. Students can still take music lessons, do art, library, gym, and Spanish too. With more time at home, students and parents are finding creative things to do together as a family. We love their pictures. But we all agree, much has changed, and it's very, very different.
Grandparents, you are our family connection to faith in God, the God who is perfectly faithful to us, who never changes, though life brings us many changes. 1 Corinthians 13:13 reminds us that out of all the amazing things that we enjoy about our world, our relationships, our daily lives, all the good things that God has given us to experience and enjoy, when it's all said and done, these three remain: faith, hope, and love. Christian grandparents are so valuable in the lives of their grandchildren because you, grandparents, have been there. You have seen a lot of life and experienced a lot of God's faithfulness already. Grandparents, you tell the stories of the hard times and stories of the good times, the times that give witness to God's goodness and to God's love. Grandparents, you pass on faith to your grandchildren, especially now, is something that we at DC cherish and highly value. With that in mind, and hoping to honor our grandparents' faith and wisdom, we ask some of you to share some encouragement and advice for kids in a time like this. We gave some of you this sentence to complete: God is. And we gave some of you the task of giving wise advice on how to keep the faith, meaning how to get along well with school at home. Thank you for your messages of encouragement.
God is with you always. He's with you in the morning. He's with you at night when you're asleep. There is never a need to be afraid of anything because God is always with you.
Being a retired kindergarten teacher, I love word pictures, and I can remember a time when I was going through a really difficult time, and I remember crying out to the Lord and saying, "Lord, I feel like I'm hanging on by a thread." And I heard him say in my heart, "But remember, I'm holding on to the other end." So boys and girls, mom and dad, if you feel like you're holding on by a thread during this uncertain time, remember who's holding on to the other end.
God is faithful. He has given you a wonderful legacy at Delaware County Christian School. Your mom and dad, Ginny and Jake, uncles Russ, Steve, and Jim, and Aunt Jen. During this time of pandemic, God is sovereign and He is in control.
And remember Proverbs 3, 5, and 6. Trust in the Lord with all your heart.
And do not lean on your own understanding.
In all your ways acknowledge Him.
And He will make your path straight.
We love you, JoJo.
Your parents are telling you, the brother of Jesus also told us to wash our hands. In James 4:8, we read, "Wash your hands, you sinners." And then James adds, "Purify your hearts." So your great-grandmother was right when she would urge me to have clean hands and a pure heart.
And Arthur's Nini and Pap.
Did you know that God is light? So show the light of God by being friendly and smiling.
Did you know that God is life? So be the best person that you can be.
Did you know that God is love? We love you, Henry.
We love you, Arthur.
And we love all the kids, the teachers, and staff of the Delaware County Christian School.
This is our 17th and final Grandparents' Day at the lower school. We're most grateful for the loving bond that we've seen between our 7 grandchildren and each of their teachers.
That close relationship between students and teachers who love the Lord is invaluable. Continue watching and encouraging those precious relationships for many years to come.
Levi and Jordan, this is Oma.
And this is Opa. And we are here to remind you to say your prayers and brush your teeth before you go to bed at night.
And sleep tight. Don't let the bed bugs bite. Be good. We love you and listen to your teachers. God bless you.
Hello, everybody. We are Joanne and Harry Johnson, and we're the proud grandparents of our Joelle Johnson in fourth grade. This is such a strange time that we're in right now that we've never experienced either, but we just want to remind you that our God is over all of this, and He will end this pandemic very soon. I really believe that. But in the meantime, what can you do? I think you could finish your homework and read some books, do some special projects, and be sure to get outside for a walk or to play.
And don't forget your music.
Yes. And remember that we love you, and we just can't wait to see you very soon, I hope.
We are grateful to God for our 2 wonderful grandsons, Henry and Jack.
And their parents, Jeannie and Tim, and a wonderful school with loving teachers.
Everybody, we're Mark and Carla Johnson, proud grandparents of Asher and Luke Potofsky, and we'd like to say hi to all of our friends at DC, and we'd like to say thanks to the leaders and teachers of DC for carrying on school during this time of coronavirus.
Now, we hope you're having some fun, and I want to remind you to wash your hands. And then bake some cookies and have a scavenger hunt. Go outside and plant something. But whatever you do, as it says in Galatians 3, do it all in the name of Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father. Bye, kids. Stay well.
Take care.
Everyone, this is Jada's grandma. I just wanted to share that God is awesome. Even in these most difficult times, we have to remember that His word is true. He will never leave us and never forsake us. So we have to keep the faith and always remember, no matter what we go through in life, that He is always with us. Because God is
with us. Hi, awesome. Josie, Addie, Micah, Lucy, Andrew, and Ben.
We have missed you so much during this pandemic. This is our first experience ever keeping social distancing from everyone. And it's also our first time doing Zoom meetings, just like you are all doing.
We are trusting the Lord and praying for each one of you every day. Remember to always trust in Jesus with all of your hearts.
We love you higher than the moon and the stars, but Jesus loves you so much more than that.
Never forget that God loves you.
Hi. In these confusing times, whenever you're frustrated or anxious and need someone to talk to, remember you can always talk to your grandparents. Give us a call. We'll listen to you.
Thank you, grandparents. Your faith, wisdom, and encouragement is so appreciated. Let's return now to 1 Corinthians 13:13 to finish our time together on this virtual Grandparents Day with a little bit of love for you, grandparents, from our students.
Thank you.
Thank you, students, grandparents, teachers, and parents, for joining together to make this virtual Grandparents Day 2020 a special one. As a group, we all work together to accomplish our DC promise to prepare students for a life of impact through an innovative and exemplary education rooted in Christ. As we close today, it is good to remember that even when life changes dramatically, faith, hope, and love abide. These are gifts that come from the very being of God Himself, who never changes. Mrs. Ludwig, our head of the lower school, is now going to come with a word and to close us in prayer.
This has been a very different Grandparents' Day. I hope that you have enjoyed hearing a little bit about our school year together and how much we appreciate you. And we've appreciated the wisdom that our grandparents have shared with us this morning as well. Grandparents' Day is one of my favorite days in the school year, so I'm so glad that we could bring this morning to you, albeit in a very different format. Each year, we take special joy in sharing with our grandparents our student artwork. Typically, you would see this hanging all around our school. But this year, we created a virtual art show. This can be seen on our school's website. I hope you will take a minute to see some of the exciting artwork that our students have created this year. Let's close in prayer. Gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for the continual reminder that our lives are in your care and that you sustain all things. Although we could not be together physically, walking the halls of the school this morning and greeting our grandparents in person, we know the heart of the school is the people who work and learn in it. We're grateful that we could share the joy of Christian education together with our grandparents this morning. Lord, thank you for every person watching today and for what they mean to our students and for the influence and impact they have each day in guiding them to understand and love you more. We ask for safekeeping for all of our grandparents during these days of social distancing. May you go before them and keep them in your care until we can be together face to face. May their hearts be encouraged with the knowledge that they are deeply loved by you and their grandchildren. In Jesus' name, amen.